Hi, welcome to this short video series on how to format, import, and autocode NVivo header formatted transcripts. In this first video, I'm going to show you how to format Microsoft Word transcripts with heading styles before you import them into NVivo. Now, there are two key elements you will need to format into your transcripts before you import them into NVivo. The first one is all your speaker identification, question, topical headings must be in standalone paragraphs. The second, you must apply consistent heading styles to the identifier, questions, or topical headings. Now, let's get to it. Here, we have a typical transcript with a speaker identifier, mic, who is the interviewer, and Matt, who is the interviewee or the respondent. And in the transcripts, we have everything that Mike said and everything that Matt said. So, keeping in mind the two key elements that you need to have in an NVivo header formatted transcript, the first element is that the speaker identifier must be in a standalone paragraph. Let me show you the paragraph marks in this transcript by clicking on this button. And so here we can see the paragraph marks and other markings that are in the transcript. As you can see, after the speaker identifier, we have a tab character and then what they said and then a paragraph mark, which means all this is in one paragraph. Now we need Mike, the identifier, to be in its own standalone paragraph. So how do we accomplish that in Word? The easiest way is to use the find and replace function in Microsoft Word. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to find every colon and tab and replace it with a paragraph mark. Okay? To do that, I'm going to use the find and replace in Microsoft Word. So I'm going to go to replace and I'm going to replace the colon and the tab, which I get from special characters tab, and I'm going to replace this with the colon again, but instead of the tab, I'm going to do a paragraph mark, and then I'm going to replace all, and that's what I want. Okay, close, and with a few clicks, I've fulfilled the first element of a header formatted transcript. All the speaker identifiers must be in their own paragraph. Now, once I'm done with that, I'm going to select all the transcript and align it. You don't need to necessarily do that, but you know, it looks better. And so now the second element that we need to introduce in this transcript is we need to mark the speaker identifiers with a header style. Now, I recommend use header 1 or header 2 styles for your speaker identifier. So you can click on each manually and add them, okay? But there's a faster and easier way to do that. And again, we are going to use the find and replace. So go to replace, you're gonna look for Mike, and we're gonna replace it with Mike again. Now, if you don't find this part of the find and replace, the advanced part, when you open find and replace, you might see this. And so to unlock the advanced feature, you just click on more. Now, what we want to do is replace the mic with a mic with a header style. And so to do that, you click on format and style, and you select your heading style, either header 1, header 2, header 3, 4, 5, any of these heading styles is good. Now, I have created my own heading style that is called header NVivo, and I'm going to use that. But you can use any one of these and you should be fine if you don't want to create your own. I wanted to create one just for ease of reference later on. So that's what I want to replace all my heading with. And so I create OK. Now, as you can see, it's going to be replaced with Mike with the style that's going to be head NVivo, which is the style that I've created. And so if you click on replace all, it has done 17 replacements and all of our mic has the head NVivo heading style. Now, we need to be consistent, okay? You don't want the first mic to be a different heading style than the second mic. So they all have to be in the same heading style. That's why I prefer using the final replace rather than doing it manually, one by one. Now, we need to do the same thing for mat. So just click mat and change this to mat and replace all, and we are good to go. And there you can see all my speaker identifiers are on their own paragraph, standalone paragraph, and they have been marked with a consistent heading style. And that's how you format Microsoft Word transcript with heading styles. In the next video, I'll show you how to import the header formatted transcript we've just created into NVivo 11. See you then.